guest now is Yvette Wyatt. She is a witch and conjure worker and will be part of Detroit Witches Bazaar, which will be held this coming Saturday, October 23rd, at the Hilton Garden Inn in Southfield from 9 a.m. until 3 p.m. Yvette, thanks for being with us today.
Thank you for having me.
Appreciate having you on. So you are a witch and a conjure worker, a lifetime Detroiter, and you began seeing spirits as a child. Tell us a little bit about your early experiences and how that led you into your current work.
Well, I think for many people, it's a lifestyle. This is a lifestyle. So my grandmother understood what I was seeing. My mother, of course, thought I was something was wrong with me, but my grandmother understood it. Many African traditions are looked at different, but it's not, and it's not really spooky. I mean, because energy never leaves. So when someone passes away, their physical body's left, but their energy is still there.
We're joined by Yvette Wyatt. Yeah, we're joined by Yvette Wyatt. She's a witch and conjure worker with us. She'll be at Detroit Witches Bazaar this coming Saturday, October 23rd, at the Hilton Garden Inn. So, for those that aren't familiar with the work that you do as a witch and a conjure worker, tell us a little bit about your work and some of the services that you do provide to people through that work.
Well, I own a store in Detroit called the Motown Witch. We do candles, incense, oils. I do consultations with people to help them get their spirits in a better place, so to speak. I don't do the stereotypical love work thing and all that death hex, all that. I don't do any of that kind of thing. I try to help people find their peace within themselves. It's really a holistic practice.
And so you'll be joining a number of other people and other vendors at Detroit Witches Bazaar on Saturday. For those that are going and will see you at the Witches Bazaar, what can they expect to be able to communicate with you, or maybe services that they can have provided by you at the Detroit Witches Bazaar at the Hilton Garden Inn this Saturday?
Well, actually, this is actually my event, so I'm not going to have a table. I have 40 vendors. I have 40 vendors. There are tarot readers, oracle card readers. They make potions. There's potion makers. There's altar making. Body butters, oils, incense, soaps. There's 40 different vendors there that we can. And actually, the bazaar is before the ball. That night is a ball. We have a formal black tie event that night.
And so there seems to be a large number of people that are really into this kind of stuff and do believe in everything that your vendors and the work that you do and all that. But there are a lot of people that also will look at this from the outside looking in without an open mind and think that this is all crazy. Is this event also for them? Is this for people that are really into this kind of stuff? Or is it also for people that are kind of on the outside looking in, maybe don't believe in this stuff, maybe are just curious about it and can come here and speak with these vendors and interact with them and ask questions and maybe along the way be more open to some of these ideas?
It's for everyone. There's no exclusion. It's for everyone. Even the ball is for everyone. The ball is just called the Detroit Witches Ball, but it's an open a party that's catered, and for the price that you pay, you get dinner and you get a open bar. So, and I encourage people not to drink and drive and get a discounted room by saying you're with the that you're at the ball. It's for everyone. You can come, you can learn, you can look, you can just buy soap or just buy candles. It doesn't have to be anything with a magical purpose, you know what I mean?
We're joined by Yvette Wyatt. She is a witch and conjure worker and is leading the Detroit Witches Bazaar, which is an event that will be held this Saturday, October 23rd, at the Hilton Garden Inn in Southfield from 9 a.m. until 3 p.m. And then that night at the same location at the Hilton Garden Inn from 9 p.m. to midnight will be the Detroit Witches Ball. And so if there is a big metaphysical, pagan, ATR Michigan community that maybe isn't as well known as it probably should be outside of those circles. Tell us a little bit about just how extensive of a community we have in those regards across the state of Michigan.
It's huge, actually, because actually there's two balls. There's another one, I don't know their location, but there's another one called the Michigan Midwest or the Midwest Michigan's Witches Ball. It's the weekend after mine. Unfortunately, in Michigan, there's that racial divide. So for years, I've been a part of the other one, but there's always the other people who don't want to go to that one. So I kind of opened up a gateway for everyone so that now everyone can come to this one as well.
We're joined by Yvette Wyatt, a witch and conjure worker. She also is leading the Detroit Witches Bazaar, which is an event that will be held this Saturday, October 23rd, at the Hilton Garden Inn in Southfield from 9 a.m. until 3 p.m., as well as one of those balls that she was talking about. The Detroit Witches Ball will be held at the same location, the Hilton Garden Inn in Southfield, from 9 p.m. until midnight that day as well. So, Yvette, for those that are interested in this event, where can they find more information? How can they, is this a free event or are there tickets that need to be purchased? Where can they get all that information?
The bazaar is free. They can go to www.motownwitch.com or www.detroitwitchesball.com. And information is on both places. The bazaar is free. The ball is $50 per ticket. Tomorrow is my cutoff date because we have to get the caterers a count, a final count of how many people.
We're joined by Yvette. So where can people purchase tickets to the ball?
On DetroitWitchesBall.com, MotownWitch.com, and here at the store at the Motown Witch, which we're located at 16844 Schaefer Highway in Detroit.
So what and what will they experience when they go to this ball? And they're among other people that are from, of course, from this community and people that are outside of the Michigan ATR and metaphysical and pagan community that will also be joining them. What can they expect to experience at this ball?
Good food, good music, dancing, just dress in your finest wear. This is an actual, we don't have formal events around that often anymore. I like that kind of stuff. So that's what we're doing. I mean, that it's like I said, that's just the name of it. There's no spooky TV-oriented spellwork thing happening. It's just a party.
We're joined by Yvette Wyatt, a witch and conjure worker who is leading the Detroit Witches Bazaar. It's the first annual Detroit Witches Bazaar, featuring 50 vendors through an emporium of magical gifts, meet and speak with practitioners of various traditions. Entry to the Witches Bazaar is free. The Witches Ball is a paid event. And so this is the first annual Detroit Witches Bazaar, and it is your event, Yvette. What inspired you to form this event, to organize this event, and ultimately to hold this event coming up this weekend?
Well, like I said, there was other ones before, and a lot of people wouldn't go for various reasons, so I just opened it up for everyone to come to this one. Actually, I did a Detroit Hoodoo Festival last April, and once I pulled that off and it was easy to do, I decided to do this as well.
We're joined by
Yvette. We're doing another Hoodoo Festival next year, 2022.
We're joined by Yvette Wyatt. She is a witch and conjure worker with us on the MegaCast. She is the leader of the Detroit Witches Bazaar. That event will be held again. It'll be held Saturday, October 23rd, from 9 a.m. until 3 p.m. That is at the Hilton Garden Inn in Southfield. It is free to attend. There will be readers, artists, and vendors offering an array of beautiful, exotic, and magical creations and services at the event. And then that night, a whole different celebration. The Detroit Witches Ball will also be held at the Hilton Garden Inn on Saturday, October 23rd, from 9 p.m. until midnight. And you can learn more information and purchase tickets to the ball at DetroitWitchesBall.com. And so, Yvette, before we say goodbye today, just a few more minutes left with you today. Anything else that people should know about this event before they go? What they can expect? How they should prepare to come out to this event? Or any other information that would be interesting for our audience to know about the first annual Detroit Witches Bazaar?
Well, come out with an open mind and come out to shop and support local artisans. It's basically like an art fair, so to speak. So there's a various array of people that make a lot of different things, and it's nice. And you can learn something and see that the word witch is not the spooky ooky thing that people think it is. I've called myself a witch since I was a child, and I look at a witch as a healer.
Yeah, there are real people that are doing this work on a daily basis and are helping other people through their work as well. And so it's always important to get another person's perspective and learn a little bit about a topic or learn a little bit about a practice before you make any sort of judgment about it or make a decision yourself, because you're not always going to be an expert. But when you talk to someone that is an expert that has done this, you come in with that open mind and maybe you learn something and find a new interest as well, right?
Exactly. I'm just a typical grandmother of four, almost five grandsons. I mean, I'm just grandma. It works.
Well, Yvette, we thank you very much for previewing this event with us, for showing us some ways to come in with an open mind and garner some interest for a really interesting event that you're putting on this Saturday at the Hilton Garden Inn in Southfield. We appreciate it.
Thank you for inviting me.